In antkeeping, there are a few basic golden rules of ethics that most antkeepers follow. First, don't keep non-local ants. Doing so endangers your ecosystem and the ants themselves. Second, pre-kill your prey insects. It's cruel and can be dangerous to your ants to feed live prey. And finally, we antkeepers know to never, ever mix your colonies together. This would cause an ant war. Today, I broke this last rule because I had heard that yellow crazy ants can fuse colonies. In fact, the Golden Empire today, as we saw in a past video, is the result of two colonies that joined forces. This is why when I received this new five queen colony of yellow crazy ants, it never occurred to me that the ants would end up going to war. AC family, sit tight, because today we will see what can happen when the basic rules of antkeeping are broken. Will there be mass death from an ant war? Or will the ants join forces? AC family, put on your strongest of armor and carry your most solid shields as we watch an epic battle unfold before our very eyes. It's every antkeeper's nightmare and delight to all those who have asked me to warm my ant colonies. You won't want to miss all the ant action ahead, so keep on watching until the end. A warning to all antkeepers out there not to try this with your ants at home. This episode was not planned the way it turned out, but what happened will surely shock you. Gather around, AC family, and let's learn about the amazing ways of ant colony fusion and ant war in another action-packed episode where we marvel at the amazing world of ants, here on the AntsCanada Ant Channel. Please subscribe to my videos. You won't regret entering this ant universe. Hit that bell icon too to join the AC notification squad. Enjoy. So before the ant lovers of the world start attacking me, here's my defense. Someone offered me this large yellow crazy ant colony through the GAN project, and I, at first, was hesitant to take them. The Golden Empire was still recovering from their mite infestation, and I was happy with their growth in size since I first got them. But then I went back to what our mite biologist told us about what causes mites to enter the phoretic state, meaning the life stage where they go from beneficial mites that eat the ants' garbage to hitchhikers, where they attach themselves to the ants' bodies. The mite biologist had said that one of the causes of mite phoresis is if the ants were already suffering from a health condition, if the ants' health was somehow compromised in the first place. So, in light of this, I also knew that the larger an ant colony is, the greater chance of success they have at thriving, because with more workers, it means they can acquire more food for the colony, keep the nest cleaner and better maintained, have babies better fed and protected, and generally carry out all the necessary tasks required for a healthy colony. This is how I came to decide that, yes, perhaps adding this large five-queen colony of healthy ants to our Golden Empire, a three-queen colony, might prove beneficial at speeding up the riddance of our ants' phoretic mites. Tonight, I was going to break our third golden rule of antkeeping ethics. I did it before with this colony, and other than one of the queens retaliating for a bit, it was fine. I assumed this induced colony fusion now would also be problem-free. But little did I know, I was in for a shocking surprise. Night fell, and the colony was in place. If you've been AC family for a while now, you know the drill. We'll be using light and heat to move our new ants into the Hacienda del Dorado, the lush kingdom of our Golden Empire. The tube which was to be the bridge into the Hacienda del Dorado was covered with baby powder on one end to keep the ants inside the terrarium from crawling out. I unwrapped the container to reveal the new foreign five-queen colony. Whoa, look at all those ants. They were restless in their container. I was told the colony was quite agitated these past few days, perhaps because they were tired of living in their plastic container. This move was going to be easy. So my plan was to disconnect this tube, which connects the main nest container, to their outworld, and connect this tube, leading to the Hacienda del Dorado, to this hole. As for the ants in the outworld, I would dump them directly into the Hacienda del Dorado afterward. I would then place the bright light over their current container to encourage them to move out. Here we go, AC family. It was time. Time to mix these two yellow crazy ants together. Here we go. The ants moved in and quickly started carrying brood out of the container and into the tubes. All seemed to be going as planned. The very first worker entered the Hacienda del Dorado without problems. It was so fast that I hadn't even seen where it went. I assumed it had found the nest under the driftwood where the Golden Empire were nestled. Without thinking anything wrong would happen, I allowed my cameras to run for 2 hours and left them to join forces. 2 hours later, I came back to a horrific sight. The new colony had moved completely into the Hacienda del Dorado, but something didn't look right. The ants seemed to be clumping. What's happening here? With a closer look, I was shocked. To my surprise, the Golden Empire and this new five-queen colony had engaged in an epic ant war. Workers were locked together, biting legs, mandibles locked, many ants clearly in agony. Oh no! What had I done? The Golden Empire was in danger, and it pained me to know that I had caused this ant war. I wasn't sure which colony would end up winning, but I knew this would definitely end in massive ant bloodshed. There was nothing I could do but watch in horror as our beloved Golden Empire fought against these newly introduced enemies. May God help the Golden Empire. The next morning, everything was still. I looked around the Hacienda del Dorado. There weren't very many workers in sight. The war had ended. Who won? How many casualties were there? With a heavy heart, I surveyed the Golden Empire's kingdom. To my surprise, I couldn't find any dead ants anywhere. What? Where did all the ants go? Last night the armies were fighting, and I was sure I was going to have to deal with piles of dead ants in the morning. But no. No dead ants. I placed a dead cockroach inside to attempt to draw the ants out from wherever they were hiding. Suddenly, it was like a ray of hope. In just a few short minutes, ants came rushing out from under the driftwood. And what made me smile was that the ants that came running out were our ants from the Golden Empire, still carrying their phoretic mites, as well as new mite-free ants, assumingly from the newly introduced ant colony from last night. Wow! The colonies had ultimately joined forces. What could have happened? Did they fight for a while and then just decide, hey guys, let's settle our differences and just become one big happy family? How about it? Whatever conspired overnight, I, for one, was relieved. Can you imagine what was going through my mind overnight, thinking about how hard it would have been to tell you guys the Golden Empire died because of a colony introduction? The breaking of a basic ant-keeping golden rule? Anyway, so the Golden Empire now officially has 8 queens, and a larger worker force now. Also, there are many ants that are now mite-free. Let's hope this greater worker force helps get rid of these phoretic mites once and for all. Another very cool thing I spotted in the Hacienda del Dorado was this. The bonsai trees were apparently carrying their own set of parasites. But in this case, it excited me because these little insects were aphids. It was my dream to find a way to properly and successfully house a colony of aphids because, as some of you may know, some species of ants love to tend aphids and other similar plant insects and milk them of their sweet secretions called honeydew. And yellow crazy ants are one of those species known to perform these aphid-tending behaviors. Yes! Can you imagine the Golden Empire farming their own sugar source all inside the Hacienda del Dorado? So far, it seemed the Golden Empire wasn't tending them yet, but I think I did catch what I thought were workers licking the leaves. Perhaps one day, the workers will discover that they can farm honeydew from the small aphids feeding from the bonsai trees. Isn't that cool, AC fam? I will be sure to keep you guys updated on this and the overall progress of the Golden Empire. Thank you for watching another episode of the Ants Canada Ant Channel. It's been quite the journey for this golden empire. And still, the saga continues on. And we, the AC family, will be here to support and watch over them every step of the way. Won't we? Because it's ant love forever. All right. That was close, right, guys? So what do you think happened here? Why would the two ant colonies be going to war in the beginning and then decide to join forces? Let me know your take of this story in the comments section. AC Inner Colony, I've placed a hidden cookie for you here. If you would just like to watch extended play footage of the ants in this video without all the commentary. And of course, we have the AC question of the week. Last week we asked, why did this colony reject our first cockroach? Congratulations to Hexagon21, who correctly answered, they ignored the cockroach because it was too big of a prey item. Congratulations, Hexagon21, you just won a free ebook handbook from our shop. For this week's AC question of the week, we ask, what is mitophoresis? Leave your answer in the comment section and you could win a free t-shirt from our shop. Please subscribe to this channel so you don't miss a single episode. We upload a brand new ant video every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. It's Ant Love Forever.